The 90D just showed up by mistake on the Canon Australia's YouTube channel, and apparently some were able to grab the footage before it was deleted on the official channel. So it revealed pretty much everything about the soon to be launched Canon 90D. Well, right now I'm filming this video with the Canon 80D. So will I be upgrading to the Canon 90D? Well, to be honest, for some it can be a very significant upgrade to the Canon 80D, which will make the workflow faster, easier, without having to, you know, learn new things and yet be able to use the latest features such as the eye autofocus, better face detection. Autofocus captures 4K at 30 frames per second with a crop factor. Keep in mind, so crop factor again here, and 1080p at 120 frames per second. That's it. No, wait. I think majority of the features are actually carried out from the Canon EOS M50. So that's what this one looks like, because you also get the DIGIC 8 processor. That's the same processor implemented on the Canon EOS M50. So what's the new thing here on the 90D then? Oh wait. What about the image sensor? It features a new 32.5 megapixel, you heard it right, 32.5 megapixel image sensor with DIGIC 8 processor, which in my opinion, if priced right, can grab a lot of customers for an excellent all-round camera. They also added the joystick, a convenient button to fiddle around to adjust focus area. The buttons on the top side of the camera looks to be clickable now, whereas on the 80D it was recessed quite a bit. So the viewfinder now covers approximately 100%. It can shoot at 10 frames per second. I think the Canon 80D shoots at 7 frames per second, if I'm not wrong, or rather 6 frames per second. Now the Canon 90D can shoot at 10 frames per second with 45 points all cross-type autofocus. There is not much real improvement with the autofocus area here, but 45 points all cross-type, I think that suffices. Also, the battery capacity looks to be bumped up to give more backup with 1300 shots SIPA rating. So yeah, what do you guys think of this new 90D? Would you be buying it or looking elsewhere, such as Sony's A6400 or maybe Fuji X-T30, which I talked a bit about it in my earlier videos? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you ask me, this can become again a perfect all-round camera for your YouTube work as well as taking good quality pictures. It stands on its own and you don't have to actually compare it with the other camera systems. Hopefully the Canon prices it right. In my next video, I'll talk about the new Canon EOS M6 Mark II, which again was leaked. I think if priced right again, the EOS M6 Mark II can be a best value for money camera. So make sure you watch that video. I'll go through the details of the Canon EOS M6 Mark II quickly. Alright guys, before I wrap up this video, make sure to browse through my channel. I've made a lot of interesting videos on this channel. So hit that subscribe button, like this video and share it with your friends. Let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. So see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.